Kyle Lowry has been one of the leading members of what many are calling the greatest Toronto Raptor team of all time. The boys have made it to their first NBA Finals ever, and Lowry is playing a huge role. It seems like Kyle has really found his playoff rhythm, leaving fans of Jurassic Park rich with memories. But Lowry, he has some riches of his own, and according to a recent interview, he might be spending his bag on a new house in Toronto, where he'll get to hang in the offseason with some of his boys.
What do you want?
I'm here to take his daughter's house.
How old are you?
15.
You at least 30.
After originally buying a $2.65 million mansion in his hometown of Pennsylvania, well, it appears that Lowry is making some serious plans to stay in the six long term where he will raise his family. Lowry even bought a custom van complete with a chauffeur to drive him and his kids around the city. And we're still not even sure if Kyle ever bought the Aston Martin that he was asking about on Twitter back in 2012, but we definitely know that he can afford it. According to CelebrityNetWorth.com, Kyle Lowry is worth $55 million. Now that money, it comes from a mixture of endorsements and his NBA contracts. But even with income like that, well, Kyle, he isn't one to show off his money online. Instead, he'd much rather share pictures of his beautiful family instead. Now, it was a long road for Kyle Lowry to get to the place he's at today, both financially and in his career. And in this video, well, we're gonna take a look at that journey. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Michael McCrudden taking you through the financial come up and what he spends his bag on, here for you on The Rich Life of Kyle Lowry. Now, we've been dropping all sorts of videos with the Raptors in the playoffs. We've done like half the team now. Also, we've done some rich lives on some of the guys from the other team. But our Kawhi Leonard one, it's the best. Because, you know, we have this cut in. We also did one on Superfan Navbatia. That one actually did pretty well. Anyways, guys, you gotta let us know who's next in the comments down below. And as we do in The Rich Life, well, I'm gonna ask you guys a trivia question. And I'll answer that a little later in this video. What TV show was Kyle Lowry watching a marathon of during the 2014 offseason? Off the top of my head, I'm gonna guess Prison Break. But place your guesses down below. Now let's roll that intro. Oh yeah, we're also working on an epic video of the Raptors. We're gonna drop that this weekend, maybe in a few days. So be sure to turn on post notifications. You're not gonna wanna miss it. It's epic. Kyle Lowry was born on March 25th, 1986 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He was raised by his mother, Marie Holloway, and although his dad lived just 10 minutes away from their North Philly home, well, his dad, he didn't play a very big role in Kyle's life. Now, it was actually Kyle's older brother, Lonnie Jr., who first taught Kyle how to dribble a basketball with his offhand so that he could become a better ball handler. Now, Kyle was only 8 years old when he started to perfect his skills on the court with the older kids in the neighborhood, which was probably good practice, because, you know, he still ain't the tallest glass of water on the court. You know, it's fair.
This is the park, man. This is really where I used to be at. The competition was crazy.
After being convinced by his youth league coach, Dave Distel, well, Lowry played for Cardinal Daughtry High School in Philly, where he was a point guard and was considered a five-star recruit. According to Rivals.com, he was listed as the number 6 ranked point guard and number 28th best player in the nation in 2004. His high school numbers got him a scholarship to Villanova, where he became a member of the Big East All-Rookies team, as well as the Philadelphia Big 5 Rookie of the Year. Now, Kyle, he averaged 7.5 points, 3.2 rebounds, 2 assists, and 1.3 steals per game in his freshman year. Now, as a sophomore, he had another stellar year, and he decided to put his name into the NBA draft.
The Memphis Grizzlies select Kyle Lowry of Villanova University.
He was drafted at number 24 by the Memphis Grizzlies in the 2006 NBA draft. But his road to becoming one of the best point guards in the league, it was a long one. In his rookie season, he suffered a broken wrist after just 10 games, and he underwent season-ending surgery. Even when he did return, his minutes, they started to dwindle as Memphis gave more court time to guard Mike Conley instead. Lowry didn't see himself as a backup point guard and wasn't very happy with the coaches or in the locker room. So then he got traded to Houston in 2009, where he would make the playoffs for the first time. But once again, he became a backup point guard as the Rockets, they went with Aaron Brooks as their starter instead. In 2010, he signed a 4-year deal with the Rockets worth $23.5 million. But Lowry clashed with his coaches in Houston once again. Yeah, he wasn't happy with that situation. I just had a visual of Mike the situation. Anyway, it was then he got moved to Toronto in 2012 that he began to take shape as an all-star point guard. In 2013, the Raptors, they hired a new general manager, Masai Ujiri. And just make sure I'm saying that right, let's roll this.
Masai Ujiri.
Masai, you gyri.
Masai, he saw the potential in the kid from Philly and knew that he was much more than just a backup point guard. Masai, he knew that Lowry had the qualities of an NBA star and sat down with him for a meeting that would change everything. He asked Lowry, do you want to be a 3 million player, 2 million player for the rest of your career, or do you want to be a 10 million player or more? Now Lowry, he must have answered with the latter because after proving to be a consistent leader on and off the court, well, in 2014, he signed a 4-year, $48 million deal to continue playing for the Raptors. And more recently, well, he signed a brand spanking new 3-year, $100 million contract with the good old Raps. In the 2017 to 2018 season, he was averaging $406,000 per game. Damn! And in his contract, there is an incentive to make the All-Star team, as Kyle takes home an additional $200K for each appearance as an All-Star. Yeah, not bad. And whether it was the monetary incentive or just Lowry's hunger for competition, well, he's been selected to 5 straight All-Star games. But you know what? Still, not everyone's impressed.
Toronto needs to get rid of Kyle Lowry ASAP. If I have to watch that fat attempt to take a 3 one more time, I'm jumping off a building.
Now, of course, his contract isn't his only stream of revenue. The man's also got a few endorsements. Now, Lowry, he inked a deal with Citizen Watches back in 2014, and he's appeared in commercials for brands like Sports Check and Adidas. On why he signed with Adidas, or Adidas, he stated,
here's some money, and, you know, just go out there and do your job. And, you know, they always supported me, gave me a plethora of gear, took care of my family, took care of my friends, and it was big. That was an important thing.
People out in Europe, they call it Adidas. Now, Lowry, he's also been able to collaborate with the Canadian clothing brand Roots on his own official line. Remember them? They used to have it on in the butt. It was huge here in Canada. And more recently, he was featured in an ad for Google. And I'm sure that Google money, well, it had to have been pretty good.
Hey, Google. Lights out.
Sure, turning the lights off.
In terms of what Lowry spends his money on, he's honestly a pretty low-key guy with his bank. He doesn't flex very much for the gram and doesn't usually wear anything too flashy for the games. For his cars, well, we can assume he got a free car from Ford after filming a commercial for the company with his old buddy DeMar DeRozan. Who doesn't miss that bromance?
Hey, listen, y'all see who the real driver is.
I'm helping you out by pulling a brake.
Hey, y'all need to let me have this car.
It's actually a little sad to see them having so much fun together. But even though DeMar isn't in Canada anymore, the two have remained great friends off of the court. But he may have wanted more than just a Ford, because in 2012, well, Lowry tweeted at his fans asking if they knew what kind of car this was. A fan replied letting him know that it was an Aston Martin DB9, which cost around $100,000 to $150K. Now, although there haven't been any pictures of Lowry spotted with that car since, in fact, there hasn't been any pictures of him spotted in a car at all. We're not even 100% sure if he can even drive. Now there's a story about him and DeMar wanting to get a McFlurry from McDonald's at 3 a.m. But since all that was open was the drive-thru, and neither one of them had a car, well, they couldn't experience the greatness of a late-night, early-morning McFlurry. Damn! You know, a bromance, you need a McFlurry once in a while. What else are two athletes gonna do? So what does Kyle Lowry spend his money on besides McFlurries? Well, his first big purchase was a house in Wayne, Pennsylvania. Now Lowry, he bought a nearly 10,000 square foot, $2.65 million mansion in Philly that included 6 bedrooms, 8 bathrooms, 4.5 acres, and a 6-car garage. The house also included a media room, a game room, and even a home gym. And we can't forget to mention, there's also a backyard pool. No built-in McFlurry machine though, unfortunately. Now the house sold for $2.75 million in 2016, and that same year, well, Kyle, he settled in Toronto after having an incredible year on the court. Now his downtown residence, it put him within walking distance of the Air Canada Centre. But around those parts, you gotta watch out for flying chairs. Toronto chair girl, she ain't messing around. Lowry is a family man, and alongside his wife Ayana, well, he's been raising his 2 children in Toronto since the family moved here. Now, during an interview with Sportsnet, he says that his kids, they're signed up for a handful of after-school sports. We're talking swimming, basketball, soccer, and even chess. And the family, well, they're able to spend time together on the road as Lowry takes his kids with him in a chauffeur-driven van. And the kids, well, they also love to spend some time in the Raptors locker room. So it appears that Lowry is looking to stay in Toronto for the long term and for the sake of his family. Stating in a Players Tribune article, it would have been about truly leaving, leaving his friends, leaving his school, leaving this city that he's grown attached to. We would have been leaving a place that is really just a, you know, it's part of our family now. We'd have been leaving home. He continued to show love for Toronto, stating, I'm coming back to Toronto because my heart is telling me that it's home and because staying home for me and my family feels like the right thing to do. My heart is telling me that this is the best city in the world, with the best basketball fans in the world. He truly has become an ambassador for the city, and the city loves him back just as much. But Kyle and his wife, they give just as much back to the city as they've gotten from it. Now, they founded a charity that runs both in Toronto and Philly called the Lowry Love Foundation. Now, the charity has the goal of improving the lives of underprivileged and disadvantaged youths within the city and, to try and improve their quality of life. Did I just say youths? I meant youths.
Did you say youths?
Yeah, two youths.
Lowry also spends his money on a personal chef to cook his meals before every game. And most recently, he even bought everyone on the Raptors custom-made Beats headphones with their name and number engraved in the box. It's pretty sweet. Yeah, dude's a true leader. But when he's not battling on the court and taking charges, well, he's probably just sitting at home watching The Simpsons. Or at least he was back in the 2014 offseason. That's according to an old article. And there you have your answer to the question from the top of this video. Boom! Sorry, I just had to cut that in again somewhere. All right, that's all I got for you guys in this video. Be sure to let us know who's next on another episode of The Rich Life. My name, of course, is Michael McCrudden. We make all sorts of videos for you guys. So be sure to subscribe, turn on post notifications. We got an epic video on the Raptors coming soon. See you guys in another video. Boom! Summer just hit. I haven't sweated on camera in like this in a long time. Oh, God.